Good evening. It's 8 o'clock. The top headlines tonight. The day after the violence at Red Fort, the aftermath. Two farmer leaders quit the agitation. Others are firm about continuing. Also, injured cops give NDTV a first-hand account of the violence they faced. Farmer rioters or a government conspiracy? The political blame game begins. The Home Minister today meets the IB chief and the top Delhi cop. Meanwhile, the Congress and AAP target the Prime Minister and Home Minister. The IMF says India will have the highest GDP growth in this year. Markets meanwhile tank. The Sensex crashes by nearly 1,000 points. I am Shiva. The coronavirus comes from me, says a mother accused of killing her daughters in a rant. Is a pandemic of mental health now being ignored? Sourav Ganguly is in hospital after chest pain just weeks after stents were put in. Doctors say vital parameters are stable. There will likely be fresh stenting tomorrow. Our lead story, the day after the violence at Red Fort. Well, the aftermath is that 300 cops are injured, many of them in hospital. 50 people have been arrested and at least 24 FIRs filed. 40 farmer leaders who negotiated with the government are facing police charges. Meanwhile, controversially, Deep Sidhu, the actor who's being blamed by unions for sparking up the violence, isn't named in any FIR. The violence has also left farm protesters divided. Two unions left the Farmers Coalition today. Meanwhile, a new D-Day, as farmer unions have announced a march to Parliament on Monday. That's Budget Day. Also, the BJP, Congress and AAP are now all trading charges over who was responsible for the Republic Day violence.
Who is to blame for a largely peaceful movement spiraling into violence? If the farm organizers are to be believed, it's these two men. Deep Sidhu, an actor who became one of the many celebrities endorsing the farmer protests, and Satnam Singh Pannu, leader of one of the many unions combating the farm laws. Pannu, the organizers said, deviated from the plan and broke through police barricades to enter central Delhi. Pannu admitted to NDTV that he did break through barriers, but that's because the farm organizers diluted the route of the yatra. Pannu, however, claims he was not responsible for the violence at the Red Fort. For that, he too blames Sidhu. Sidhu himself was seen on his Facebook Live streaming the hoisting of the flag at Red Fort.
एक आइसोलेशन में या आज की घटना नहीं है ये एक लंबा प्रोसेस था उसकी कंटिन्यूशन है
Since then, Sidhu has not been seen either at Singhu or Tikri border, nor has he come out in public to respond to the allegations against him. Sidhu's presence at Red Fort has stoked the conspiracy theory of a BJP hand in the riots. Sidhu was campaign manager for film star and BJP MP Sunny Deol in the 2019 Lok Sabha election. The BJP has denied any such link, but curiously, Sidhu is not named in any of the police FIRs into the Delhi violence. Instead, the police have named Yogendra Yadav, Darshan Pal, Kulwant Singh Sandhu and 34 others.
Deep Sidhu ki pure samay Lal Kile mein maujoodgi, is updarav mein maujoodgi, किसान आंदोलन को बदनाम करने की एक सुनियोजित साजिश है
Even if Pannu or Sidhu had a role to play, it's unclear if either could have triggered the chaos at the Red Fort. Questions remain over why the police couldn't prove such a large-scale assault on a highly protected monument. Questions also remain over why the main organizers did not intervene much earlier when they sensed that the protest is going off tracks. With camera person Xavier, this is Arvind Gunasekar for NDTV.
And Red Fort, of course, the historical focus of Republic Day celebrations. But here's what it was like a day after the violence that erupted yesterday.
We are at the Red Fort. Let's give you a picture of the extent of damage here at the Red Fort. In fact, the protesters, after they entered the Red Fort, the police personnel deployed here. They tried to stop them, but the police personnel were assured they were outnumbered here. So the protesters, they pushed the Delhi police personnel towards this particular area where a camera person can show you. So these are the railings that were put here. So because the protesters pushed the Delhi police personnel, they didn't have an option. So what they did was they started jumping, they started scaling down the walls. So they jumped into this pit. So to save themselves, they jumped into the pit. So that's where you could see all these railings here. Everything has been destroyed here. So that's a clear picture of the damage that has been done to this particular wall.
आप देखें कि ये एक बोर्ड है जिसमें लिखा हुआ है टिकट घर, इसको तोड़ दिया गया। ये एसी वगैरह हैं, इनको तोड़ा गया। ये ग्रिल है, इसको तोड़ा गया। इस तरह से ये जो पूरी इमारत है, ये टिकट घर का शुरुआती हिस्सा है। यहाँ पर लोग आते हैं और यहाँ से टिकट लेने की प्रक्रिया शुरू होती है। चूँकि लाल किला 19 जनवरी से लेकर 26 जनवरी तक बंद था, इसीलिए अभी तो यहाँ पर जो पर्यटक हैं वो नहीं आ रहे थे, तो यहाँ पर हज़ारों की भीड़ ने उनका जो मन हुआ वो किया और ये पूरा जो हिस्सा है ये इमारत का वो तोड़ा गया है।
Those visuals, they're an indication of day after of the violence that erupted there. Meanwhile, the political blame game has begun. Home Minister Amit Shah met with the Intelligence Bureau Chief and Delhi's Police Commissioner today. But the Congress and AAP have both blamed the BJP for the violence that erupted, saying that Deep Sidhu was a political stooge.
Criminal conspiracy ka sandook kisano ke kandhon pe bandook. Aur wo baat bilkul sach sabit hui hai. ये जो लोग घड़ियाली आंसू बहा रहे थे किसानों के नाम पर, वो उनका किसानों से कुछ लेना देना नहीं था। वो शुद्ध रूप से उद्दंडता चाहते थे, एनार्की चाहते थे, अराजकता चाहते थे और उन्होंने करने की कोशिश की है।
भाजपा के एजेंट, केंद्र सरकार, मोदी की सरकार की सेंट्रल एजेंसियों के एजेंट, स्लीपर सेल में जो काम करते हैं भाजपा के, वो इस आंदोलन में इन्फिल्ट्रेट कर चुके थे, घुस चुके थे और उन लोगों ने इस
जो अग्रीमेंट के हिसाब से उन्हें दाहिने मुड़ना चाहिए था, वो दाहिने ना मुड़ करके और वहीं पे बैठ गए। उनके नेता सतनाम सिंह पन्नू, उन्होंने काफी भड़काऊ भाषण दिया, जिसके बाद वहां जो उनके साथ फार्मर्स थे उन्होंने बैरिकेड तोड़ने पे आमादा हो गए।
And what was perhaps most disturbing in the violence we saw yesterday was the way that policemen were injured and brutally beaten. NDTV reporters spoke to the policemen who were injured in the chaos. They described how the violence began.
Desperate attempts to save their lives. Cops jumped over 20 feet at the Red Fort as they tried to escape a violent mob. 32-year-old Constable Sandeep Kumar was one of those. Kumar fractured his hand and suffered injuries to his legs.
बैरिकेड्स को तोड़ते हुए, उपद्रव करते हुए, पुलिसकर्मी जितने हमारे सहयोगी थे उन सबको घायल करते हुए लाल किला तक पहुंचे थे। बार बार वो बहुत ज़्यादा एग्रेसिव मूड में आ रहे थे। उनको बहुत काफ़ी बार समझाया, वहाँ जो इनोसेंट पीपल और भी लोग आए हुए थे उनको बचाने के लिए, वो किसान नहीं, वो गुंडे, किसान गुंडे बोल लो उनको तो ये बेहतर रहेगा, क्योंकि वो लोग नशे में थे। नशे में उन्होंने किसी को नहीं देखा कि किसको मार रहे हैं, किसको छोड़ रहे हैं।
Another police officer, PC Yadav, was also at the ramparts of the Red Fort and suffered multiple injuries while trying to rescue an injured colleague.
कई तरह के हथियार थे लोगों के पास, पास तलवारें थी, भाले थे, फरसे थे, कई और सारी चीजें थी, डंडे थे। नीचे उन्होंने कुछ साथियों पे हमला कर दिया, हमारे कई साथी घायल हो गए।
At Red Fort, the forces were outnumbered. To save their lives, many ran away and even took shelter inside the homes of nearby residents.
अंदर बैठ जाओ सर, अंदर बैठ जाओ।
The violence escalated in other parts too. Several police vehicles were completely destroyed in West Delhi's Nangloi. SHO Baljeet Singh was deployed at Najafgarh in southwest Delhi. They were under strict instructions that the farmers should not be allowed into Delhi. As the farmers breached the barricades, Singh sustained fractures in both hands. He claims some were drunk.
उन्होंने बैरिकेड्स तोड़ दिए गए, बस लगी हुई थी नाले के ऊपर, बस को तोड़ना शुरू कर दिया और हमारे जेसीबी वगैरह पे भी काबू कर लिया और पथराव शुरू कर दिया, जिसके बदले में हमने आंसू गैस भी चलाई और इतने हिंसक थे कि उनके पास हर तरह का हथियार था, इवन कई लोगों ने शराबें भी पी रखी थी।
Visuals show that the protesters even snatched away weapons that belong to the police. The police has filed over 20 FIRs for rioting, damage to public property and assault on public servant with deadly weapons. The 40 farm leaders who have been negotiating with the government have also been named in an FIR filed in Nangloy. These include key leaders like Dr. Darshan Pal, Rakesh Tiket and Yogendra Yadav, who have distanced themselves from yesterday's violence.
Over 40,000 policemen, CRPF and ITBP personnel were deployed yesterday at the Singhu, Tikri and Ghazipur borders to ensure law and order. But they were outnumbered before the storm of protesters.
Senior police officials today visited the injured policemen. Over 300 of them are injured according to the Delhi police. Several protesters were also injured in the police action, but the farmer union leaders and police authorities have not declared the figure so far. NDTV Bureau report.
Well, moving to other good news, India has crossed Germany, France and Canada in the vaccinations. If you look at the global picture, we can see the United States started much before us as leading, followed by China, then the United Kingdom, Israel and the UAE. So India has now reached number 6. We are over 2 million or over 23 lakhs according to latest figures. Well above Germany, Italy, Turkey, Spain, France and Canada is even below that. So we're doing well there on vaccinations. But meanwhile, as India numbers continue to dip, COVID guidelines have been relaxed further. The Health Ministry has now permitted swimming pools to be open for all. Earlier, it was only for sports people. Also, cinema halls, theatres will operate at higher seating capacity than 50% and no restrictions on interstate, intrastate movements and no permit required. This as good news came from, well, India's capital as well. In Delhi, cases are below 100. For the first time since the end of April, Delhi recorded only 96 COVID cases in the last 24 hours. So Delhi also now the lowest amongst all Indian cities like Mumbai, Calcutta and Chennai as well. Well, the other good news coming, and we've got Geeta Gopinath of the IMF soon on this on NDTV. The IMF has said that India will have the highest GDP growth this year, but today, the day after, the Sensex has crashed by nearly 1,000 points. The Nifty also down as well.
Today was the worst losing streak in the markets since September last year. Markets ended in red for the fourth consecutive session, plunging nearly 2%. The Nifty fell below 14,000 mark for the first time this year. It shed 271 points to settle at 13,967 and the Sensex tanked by 937 points to end at 47,410. Among stocks, IndusInd Bank, Axis Bank dropped nearly 4%. HDFC Bank, HDFC, Reliance ended between 2.5 to 4% down. Among sectors, Nifty Bank lost nearly 3%. Experts say today's fall was due to profit booking ahead of the budget. Asian markets ended mixed today while European markets are trading in red.
Getting very good results and still the stocks going down 3%. It just shows that markets were over exuberant and then once the fact is coming, they're booking their profits and taking the money home. That's what's happening. So I would not read too much, at least for now.
The IMF on Tuesday forecast that India's GDP would grow at 11.5% and be the fastest growing economy for financial year 2022. But experts say markets have already factored in strong fundamentals like strong Q3 earnings and demand picking up.
IMF forecast for the Indian economy has not come as a major surprise for our market because market had already sensed the broad-based revival and we've seen the run-up in the past few months. But in terms of the flows, definitely there is going to be a positive sentiment.
Even though the markets broke down today, the experts say that one need not worry as this is the time for investors to buy at an attractive rate, because the markets are expected to remain volatile
until the union budget. In Mumbai, this is Purva Chitnis for NDTV.
Well, another tragic headline of the parents accused of killing their young daughters. The mother today in a rant said that she is Shiva, the coronavirus comes from me. Exposing also the pandemic of mental health, which seems to have worsened of the parents during this lockdown. There's also questions being raised about whether the daughters were part of these rituals, which led to their deaths.
Mother accused of killing her two daughters along with her husband in Madanapalli town of Andhra Pradesh arrested and sent to jail. The Andhra Pradesh police said the couple was highly delusional despite being highly educated.
I am Shiva. From my body particle only, Corona came. And it will come to an end in the month of March without using vaccine.
Inside their three-story home on Sunday night, police had found the bodies of the two young women in their 20s lying in a pool of blood with severe head injuries. Recent social media posts of the young women suggest they shared the beliefs of their parents and possibly willingly participated in the ritual. The father holds a PhD in chemistry and worked as a government college lecturer. The mother is a gold medalist in mathematics and was running an IIT talent school. 27-year-old Alekhya was an engineer with a management degree. And 23-year-old Sai Divya had a business administration degree and was pursuing music.
There were obviously underlying psychological issues that seemed to have got worse during the period of lockdown when the family was totally cut off from the world outside. What is clear is gross ignorance and neglect of mental health issues. With inputs from Chittoor, with camera person Nagaraju, Uma Sudhir, NDTV.